Jehová Elohim, Jehová Shalom, Jehová Sabaot, Jehová Hoseinu, Jehová Adonai, Jehová Eloheka, Jehová Mehadismen, Jehová Shama, Jehová Nisi, Jehová Sofei, Jehová Sidkeno, the Lord our righteousness, Jehová El Gibor, Jehová Eloheinu, Jehová El Shaddai, Jehová Elion, Jehová Hoseinu, Jehová El Olam, Jehová Elohi, Jehová Bara, Jehová Chizek, Jehová Magen, Jehová Ma'od, Jehová Mefalti, Jehová Misti, Jehová Sori, Jehová Kana, Jehová Yasha, Jehová Kabodi, the Lord my glory, Jehová Yireh, Goel, Hoshea, Feli, Yehova Ori, the Lord my life, Yehova Gana, he has spoken with me, blessed people, and in this conversation, this is a continuing conversation, the Lord is advancing forth, blessed people, and this day, this morning, towards the afternoon, he took prophet to Israel. And remember, it began with the Lord showing his servants that they are already in Israel, and there is a country, the altar is raised, and they are ministering the Israelis, and all of them down there where the seats are with red carpet, the seats are like theater, because you normally have the movie theater, the seats you can fold. Yeah, so they were kneeling down and repenting, a lot of them down there after they had ministered, but they all got raised. And we remember too that he showed his servants that that sanctuary is ready, and they were ministering in Israel, and it was full. So everybody was repenting. They stepped out of the seat, they were kneeling down on the carpet and repenting in Israel. Meaning he's already prepared. He has already prepared his own children for ministering. And I could see the two prophets ministering, one of them a little bit in front ahead, and he was looking down where people were kneeling down on the red carpet in Israel. And then after that, we remember so well that in the night, then the Lord now brings forth this tremendous announcement of the rapture of the church by voice. And then today, in the morning towards the afternoon, the Lord sent his two prophets to Israel again. He took me to Israel, so I saw the two of them ministering there. And then I saw the house that was prepared for them. And he now showed me how already they have entered the land. And there are people who have come cleaning the house, preparing the house, doing all the other things, cooking, they're both cooking. Also, someone cooking their meals for them every day. Already they have asked, what do you want today? And they are prepared. And then there is the one that walks with them. I think that is their translator and also security. And then the Lord now shows me a big booster, a very big booster. It looks like a booster station, like this one for TV and radio, and he says, now this booster is where you will transmit the message, and it's connected back to the station booster, a very tall one, is connected to satellite. So the Lord says, you will transmit. I saw the two prophets talking to one another. another, but the two prophets now talk to one another. And the other one asked the other, have they ever allowed you? Oh, so they have allowed me to transmit on that invitation. But the Lord said, yes, he will transmit through that TV station. Then he showed me the tall booster, and on top of the booster there is meat. That booster must be on top of a mountain, because above, at the tip of that booster, is covered by meat, up there, meat, so you can only see a portion of the booster. The booster of the TV station, and the Lord says, as the two prophets talk about that, one prophet was asking the other, in fact, it was asked one that slightly talked and asking, are they allowed you? He said, yes. The Lord answered him, he will transmit. He will transmit the messages globally through this booster, and then he said, by satellite. So it will go by satellite globally. So the Lord has already showed me even how the two prophets of Israel will transmit the message from Israel. After that, then he has also shown me how. So he already sat there, and he has been served a meal, and he has eaten a very delicious meal, very delicious. It was vegetarian. It was potato, Irish potato, well cut, and I think they used a cream of mushroom soup and prepared very nice meal for them, and they have already eaten. There was a help that was helping and cleaning the house, the house help, cleaning everything and cooking and preparing everything there. And the young man that was going with them and translating. So the Lord has spoken with me already about discharging me from this duty, from the Kenyan mission, and about relocating to Israel. And this day I have seen even the how. A few weeks ago, is it 2 weeks ago, when he showed me again that this is going to be a house. This is our house. When he passed me by the street again like this, he showed me that from the street and said, this is it. Now, the Lord has already shown me the exact booster for the TV station, transmit the messages from Israel globally. And he said that you transmit by satellite and by internet also. And that booster station for the TV is actually on top of the mountain, and half of it is covered by mist. So you can see only half of it. And he said that that is the TV station that will transmit the messages globally from Israel. And then he has also shown me where his two prophets would stay. And already I've seen the people that came. They came out to receive them, to help them. And there was a lot of people that came to help. And then there is this house help that also walks around them, cooks the food, goes to shop. I already sat and ate a delicious meal. Irish potatoes, she prepared very well and mixed it with cream of mushroom soup. I think there was a little bit of sugar or syrup used in that cooking. So it was a sweetish meal. Very delicious. The most delicious meal I've ever tasted on the face of the earth. And this already has happened. And so if you put it together, the first time when he took me again to eat and showed me the two prophets as to where they will stay, and he said, this is our house. And then he took them behind now on the street and showed them the house is this. This is what it looks like. When you come, you enter through this way. And then we also remember the conversation yesterday when he spoke this coming to Kenya. However, in that same conversation, he then presented his two prophets ministering in a sanctuary in Israel, and the altar is raised. It's like a theater, what you used to have as a movie theater or these professional theaters, where the altar is raised, and down there the seats are folded. When you get out of the seat, it folds by itself. So already I saw many people repenting down there on the red carpet after the two prophets of the Lord had ministered. One of them was a big athlete, and he was looking down. So you can see he was ministering to them down, but they were repenting. And then after that, we remember the announcement, the emergency special announcement that came in through the night when the Lord now spoke about the rapture of the church. And now today, the Lord has spoken again. He has taken me now to Israel showed me the TV booster of the TV station that is going to transmit the message to Israel and prepare all the nations of the earth. And at the same time, showed me the house that he has prepared for his two prophets in Israel. House help that is there, is cleaning, everything, caring, wearing a white T-shirt and a blue jeans. I have a lot of details. And I've already sat down and ate a very delicious meal, the most delicious meal I've ever eaten on the face of the earth. Served Irish potatoes with a mushroom, cream of mushroom soup, and very nicely, vegetarian food, but very nicely done. I think it was a little syrup, sweet syrup, that was used. It was sweet also. Very, very delicious meal. So the Messiah is coming, blessed people. And all I can say to the nation of Kenya, even as the Lord is now discharging me from this mission, this duty, I could say that every single meeting we have now is a bonus. Every single visitation, even the healing service that is going to take place probably in the next 2 to 3 weeks, that is a bonus. Any meeting, the word explosion, word conference, is going to be a bonus. And all I can say to this country is that it was indeed a great honor and pleasure to know you, to meet you on this journey. And we served you with all our hearts. We served you with all our dedication and commitment. We have indeed loved serving you. We've loved watching the story, the unfolding of your story with Jesus. And it has been a great honor to know you. And so even now, as the Lord continues to speak, to roll out his agenda for the nation of Israel, and the rapture which he has announced already, I can say it has been indeed a great pleasure for us and honor to know you and serve you. And we will remember, always remain, will always remain faithfully your servant. The Messiah is coming. Toda, toda rabba. Toda shalom. Toda. Blessed people, Jehovah Rohi is my shepherd. Jehovah Feli, the Lord, my rock. So he is my shepherd. He guides me. He guides me from place to place. Jehovah El Rohi, the Lord, my shepherd. Jehovah Feli, the Lord, my rock. And now, blessed people, I would like to share with you a second part of this conversation on this the decision by heaven to move the two glorious servants, Yahweh, to Israel. The first part I already shared with you, and I shared with you how he has shown me the satellite TV station. He showed me the booster. The booster is on the mountain. I don't know whether it's on Mount Hermon, because Hermon tends to be snowy and so forth, but it's on the mountain, and at that place it's covered by mist, and I could see only part of the booster, and that is the booster to the TV station and the radio station that will be transmitting the messages of the Lord globally to prepare the nation and to communicate to the nation what the Lord, the King, Jehovah HaMelech, the King, has spoken. And I've seen also the house. I already lived there and walked there. And he brought some people that helped. They cook food. They prepare the place. They clean. And they already served me. They served me. I've already eaten the most delicious meal ever on the face of the earth at that place. And then the sanctuary of the cloud of God. I've already seen the two prophets' ministry. One is a little tired, and the altar is raised. And now the second part of this conversation is that the Lord now has shown me how the two prophets of Yahweh, the two prophets of eternity, the prophets of heaven, the prophets of everlasting life, they that stand before the throne room of God, before the throne of God, how they began to minister to the nation of Israel. And so the Lord took them to the beaches of sexual sin, to the shore, the beaches. There was so much sexual sin and nudity there. And then immediately they struck the beaches with a very shocking, rattling earthquake. And there is an earthquake that immediately hit the beaches, the shores. And it was a long earthquake. It was not short. Immediately, the Lord commanded them to go and clean up the beaches of sexual sin. And the Lord used that to introduce them to the nation of Israel, their authority and power. And so I feel they have struck. He said, and I struck the beaches. It looks like the beaches of Tel Aviv with an earthquake, a very tremendous earthquake. It was long, it was a short earthquake. So you could hear the building. It went by the edges of the beaches like this, just by the edges, and shaking the buildings by the edges of hotels. And it was shaking. By the beaches. So there is going to be a tremendous time in the face of the earth, upon the face of this planet that is aging. Because I've seen the two prophets of the Lord after settling there, then the Lord introduces them in a very shocking manner to the nation of Israel with tremendous power and dread and fear. They command an earthquake to clean up the beaches, the nudity. There's so much nudity. There was a lot of immorality and nudity of women and everything down there. So I have seen the servants of the Lord serving the Lord in Israel, and I've seen the Lord introducing them to Israel, and then Israel began to draw to them. Israel began to come to them. All Israel, plus the leadership, began to come to them and ask them, what is the Lord Jehovah saying? What is the God of Israel saying? What should we do? And then repentance began. I have seen the administration in Israel. And I want to say that indeed it has been a blessing to serve you, Kenya. It has been a wonderful honor to get to know you and to see your wonderful story with Jesus. The Messiah is coming. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom.